Hello guys, welcome to our video of data flow in LabVIEW. So, if you have written code before in text-based programming language like Python or C++, then you are used to an execution model known as control flow. When you run your program, the code is executed sequentially, or we can say line by line from top to bottom. Sure, things like functions and if-else statement can change the flow of execution to jump around between different sections of codes. But in general, if a call function A on line 1 of my text-based program and then call function B on the very next line, I know that function A will always execute and finish before the function B begins. That makes sense for a text-based language, but in terms of LabVIEW, because LabVIEW uses graphical programming, so it uses a different model of execution based on how things are wired together. This is called data flow. LabVIEW uses wires to pass data between nodes on the block diagram, and the movement of data through the nodes determine the order in which they have to execute. If you come from a text-based background, making the mental transition to this data flow style of execution can be a little strange, but the rules are pretty straightforward. A block diagram node will only begin executing after it has received all of its required input. Then, when the node has finished execution, it can produce output data, which gets passed to the next node in the data flow path. For example, considering these 7 nodes that are wired together, these present controls and indicators, functions, and other VIs. Their physical location on the block diagram does not matter in regard to data flow. Only the wire dependencies between their inputs and outputs. That said, LabVIEW code is usually organized to execute from left to right. Data is generally passed into left side of the nodes and the outputs are on the right side. When this program is initially run, node A, C, and E will begin executing immediately because they don't have any input dependencies. If C and E finishes right away, they will pass their output data onto the node D and F. However, D and F will not be able to begin execution because they are both dependent on data from node B as well. And node B is still waiting for node A to finish execution. When node A finally finishes, node B will be able to start, and then when it finishes, it will pass its output data to node D and F. So, they both can finally begin execution. Now, here's a scenario where LabVIEW programs can sometime get into trouble. From a conceptual data flow standpoint, nodes D and F are executing at the same time. However, under the hood, the computer running the LabVIEW program may only be able to actually execute one of those routines at a time. The computer might finish executing node D before moving on to F, or it might execute F first. That's up to LabVIEW, how it compiles the program and other factors beyond the programmer's control. If both of those nodes are simple operations like math functions, then I would say it doesn't really matter which gets calculated first. But if those nodes were VIs that interfaced with hardware to initialize it and run a measurement routine, then the order in which those nodes execute is really important. If the computer tries to run the measurement before the hardware is initialized, that will almost cause a problem. To prevent that, we can create dependencies by wiring an output from initialization VI to an input to the run VI. That guarantees the init will always finish executing first. There are some other mechanisms that can enforce execution order, like LabVIEW sequence structure, but that's beyond the scope of this course. LabVIEW has a feature that animates from movement of data passing from node to node as the program execute. Let's say this dataflow.vi example program simply convert Celsius to Fahrenheit, which we created in the last video. But I have spread out the nodes to have a long wires between them. So before running it, I will click this light bulb icon on the block diagram to enable execution highlights. Now, when I run the program, you can see these tiny dots moving along the wires to indicate data flowing from one node to the next. The Celsius control and both of constants were able to supply their data immediately. Then the multiply function will run. Even though using the highlight mode will slow down the program's overall execution. The little dots move pretty fast, so they can sometimes be hard to see. But as a debugging tool, I have found highlighted execution mode useful to uncover part of my code that were never getting executed because of something wrong with the data flow. So in the next video, we would use these highlighted codes into the bigger programs. So you would see like how powerful is this in sometimes in debugging the code as well. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please don't forget to like and subscribe to support this channel, where you are gonna find a lot of lab videos and tutorials. And if you are a serious LabVIEW learner, I am gonna highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you can find my course link, where I have over 5 hours of LabVIEW videos in which I have explained each and every tool in a very detailed video with an example as well. And if you have some projects or assignments or tasks, feel free to write me on my email, which is also given in the description. Thank you.